A host of proposed new laws designed to prepare the UK for a smooth and orderly departure from the EU have been announced in the Queen's speech. Of 27 bills, 8 relate to Brexit and its implications for key industries. As well as a bill to convert EU rules into UK law, there are measures on trade, immigration, fisheries, nuclear safety, agriculture, and sanctions. But other key manifesto plans have either been axed or delayed after the Conservatives lost their majority. Proposals to axe the winter fuel allowance for well-off pensioners, scrap the triple lock on pensions, expand grammar schools and end free school lunches for all infants have been dropped, while other proposals, such as a cap on energy bills and reforms to social care funding, will be put out to consultation. Amid continuing talks with the Democratic Unionists about them supporting Theresa May's government, a Downing Street spokesman said it was confident the Queen's speech could command the confidence of the House of Commons in a vote next week. The main non-Brexit proposals include: Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn said it was a threadbare legislative programme from a government that has lost its majority and apparently run out of ideas altogether. There was no mention of US President Donald Trump's proposed state visit to the UK later this year, appearing to confirm suggestions it has been delayed. Ministers said the reason it was not included was purely because no date had been set. The Queen announced the government's legislative programme for the next 2 years at the state opening of Parliament. She was accompanied by the Prince of Wales, rather than the Duke of Edinburgh, after Prince Philip was admitted to hospital on Tuesday night. Buckingham Palace said it was a precautionary measure for treatment of an infection arising from a pre-existing condition. After failing to win the general election outright, the PM has promised to work with humility and resolve. With Brexit talks now underway, the government has set out the laws needed to leave the EU, irrespective of the final deal agreed with Brussels. At the heart of this is the so-called repeal bill, which will repeal the 1972 European Communities Act and end the jurisdiction of the European Court of Justice. It will also copy over all EU laws into UK law, with Parliament then deciding which bits to retain. The government says wherever practical the same rules and laws will apply after exit, therefore maximising certainty for individuals and businesses. The bill would give the Parliament temporary authority, via secondary legislation, to amend laws that do not operate appropriately after Brexit, while existing decision-making powers devolved to Scotland, Wales, and Northern Ireland will be maintained pending further discussion on a permanent solution. As an indication of the scale of change which Brexit will bring, 7 separate pieces of legislation are proposed to anticipate the end of EU jurisdiction and introduce national policies in key sectors. On immigration, a bill will legislate for the end of free movement from the EU and make the status of EU nationals and family members subject to UK law. Although there are no specific details about a new system, ministers say they will be able to control numbers while attracting the brightest and the best. A fisheries bill will allow the UK to take on responsibility for access to fisheries and management of its waters, while an agriculture bill will provide stability for farmers and ensure an effective system of support to replace the common agricultural policy. A new nuclear safeguards regime will be required after the UK leaves the EU and its nuclear agency EURATOM, with new powers for the Office for Nuclear Regulation. Other measures will allow for a standalone domestic customs regime, giving the UK the scope to make changes to VAT and excise rates currently determined by the EU, to pave the way for an independent trade policy and to enable the UK to implement non-UN sanctions on its own or in conjunction with allies. The PM's ambitions called. By political editor Laura Kinsberg. It was meant to be Theresa May's political coronation, but the Queen's speech has confirmed the reality of her fall from grace. The Prime Minister's ambitions for significant change at home have been culled, disappearing with her majority. But the complexity of all the work the government has ahead administratively, as the UK prepares to leave the EU, is plain to see. 8 bills on Brexit, whether on customs, agriculture, fisheries, or immigration, and each requires no less than a redesign of systems that have been in place for decades. Each will require careful political handling, at a time when the government cannot be sure of its majority and a Labour Party with wind in its sails is determined to be a guerrilla opposition, putting down amendments wherever it can, stirring political trouble because it believes power could be in reach. Read more. The government has cancelled next year's Queen's speech, so this one will cover a two-year period to give MPs more time to debate all the Brexit legislation. In the preface to the Queen's speech, Mrs. May said the programme was all about grasping the opportunities that lie ahead for the UK as we leave the EU while pledging to consult and listen to ensure the final deal had the maximum support possible. She said she was determined to see Brexit through. The remaining 19 bills, including 3 in draft form and 3 finance bills, are a mixture of new proposals and legislation carried over from the last parliament, which was cut short by the snap election. Among proposals that will not require immediate legislation, the government is to review its counter-terrorism strategy in the wake of recent attacks in London and Manchester and establish a new commission for countering extremism to stamp out extremist ideology in all its forms. In response to the Grenfell fire, a new role of independent public advocate will be created to represent bereaved families in the aftermath of disasters, while a civil disaster reaction task force could be created to increase national resilience. While there are no proposed full laws on health and education, a review of mental health legislation is planned, while a digital charter will seek to boost online safety and digital commerce. Ministers have denied that, Brexit apart, it is a thin programme, although large parts of the Tory manifesto have disappeared following the election result. Labour is putting forward an alternative version of the Queen's speech, calling for an end to austerity and huge investment in public services. Mr. Corbyn said the Prime Minister had lost political authority following the election and Labour would use every opportunity to vote down proposals which do not have public support. The Lib Dems said the Queen's speech was bereft of ideas to support the public services, while the Green Party said it was a shell of a Queen's speech from a hollowed-out government. The CBI said there had been a welcome change of tone towards business, but ministers should put pragmatism before politics over Brexit. The TUC said promises to help working people were vague. Get news from the BBC in your inbox, each weekday morning.